welcome everyone to the Cathedral. As we begin this evening's service, it's my very great pleasure to install Tom Wilson as our Vice Chancellor and to pray for God's blessing on Prebendary Alan Moses as he prepares for his ministry as Succentor. As Vice Chancellor, Tom will be developing the Cathedral's academic programme and looking for new ways for the Cathedral to be a theological resource for the diocese. And as Succentor, Alan will be supporting the liturgical and musical life of the Cathedral during the period when the precentor is interim dean. The congregation, please be seated.
Dean, I present to you Thomas Wilson to be admitted as Vice Chancellor of this Cathedral Church of the Blessed Virgin Mary of Lincoln.
Thomas, do you wish to be admitted to this office?
I do.
Do you promise obedience to the Dean and Chapter and to all who are set over you in this place? Thomas, I admit you as Vice Chancellor of this Cathedral Church of the Blessed Virgin Mary of Lincoln, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
We place you, brother, into the stall assigned to you. The Lord keep watch over your coming in, your going out, from this time forth and forevermore.
Amen.
God, the giver of all good gifts, by your Holy Spirit you have appointed various ministries in the church. Look with love on your servant Alan, now called to be Succentor of this Cathedral Church. Maintain him in truth and renew him in holiness, that by word and good example he may faithfully serve you to the glory of your name and the benefit of your people. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
May Almighty God bless you. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. As our Saviour Christ hath commanded and taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. O Lord, save your servants. Let the enemy gain no advantage over them. Be to them, O Lord, a strong tower. O Lord, hear our prayer. Let us pray. O God, our beginning and our ending, we praise you that you give us grace and strength to serve you, and that you have called your servants into the fellowship of this cathedral foundation. Grant them such love for you and for your people that they may take up their cross each day and follow in the steps of your Son. May they be so encouraged by their fellowship and unity with us that they may be a strength to others. May their prayers combine with ours to come into your presence, and may your Holy Spirit lead them day by day until they come to your everlasting kingdom. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Service continues now as we sing the office hymn for Advent from the Green Hymnals, hymn number 1.
Thank you.
congregation are invited to be seated whilst the choir sing the psalm appointed for this evening, Psalm 9.
Thank you. first lesson is taken from the prophecy of Zephaniah, the third chapter, beginning at the 14th verse. Sing aloud, O daughter Zion, shout, O Israel. Rejoice and exult with all your heart, O daughter Jerusalem. The Lord has taken away the judgments against you. He has turned away your enemies. The King of Israel, the Lord, is in your midst. You shall fear disaster no more. On that day it shall be said to Jerusalem, do not fear, O Zion. Do not let your hands grow weak. The Lord your God is in your midst, a warrior who gives victory. He will rejoice over you with gladness. He will renew you in his love. He will exult over you with loud singing, as on a day of festival. I will remove disaster from you, so that you will not bear reproach for it. I will deal with all your oppressors at that time, and I will save the lame and gather the outcast, and I will change their shame into praise and renown in all the earth. At that time, I will bring you home, at that time when I gather you, for I will make you renowned and praised among all the peoples of the earth, when I restore your fortunes before your eyes, says the Lord. Here ends the first lesson. Thank you.
The second lesson is taken from the first letter of St. Paul to the Thessalonians, chapter 4, beginning at the 13th verse. But we do not want you to be uninformed, brothers and sisters, about those who have died, so that you may not grieve as others do who have no hope. For since we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so, through Jesus, God will bring with him those who have died. For this we declare to you by the word of the Lord, that we who are alive, who are left until the coming of the Lord, will by no means precede those who have died. For the Lord himself, with a cry of command, with the archangel's call, and with the sound of God's trumpet, will descend from heaven, and the dead in Christ will rise first. Then we who are alive, who are left, will be caught up in the clouds together with them to meet the Lord in the air. And so we will be with the Lord forever. Therefore, encourage one another with these words. Here ends the second lesson.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Ghost, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. He descended into hell. Congregation are invited to be seated whilst the choir sing this evening's anthem, Jesus Christ, the Apple Tree, by Elizabeth Poston. Let us pray. As this evening we give thanks for the installation of Mr. Thomas Wilson as Vice Chancellor within the Cathedral, we give thanks for all those who encourage the love of learning. O God, who art the goal of all knowledge and the source of all truth, who dost lead humanity towards thyself along the paths of discovery and learning, direct with thy wise spirit the work of education in this and every place. Especially, we would pray for those who have the task of promoting learning within this cathedral church. Asking this through Jesus Christ, our Lord. We pray for the forthcoming ministry of Preparatory Alan Moses as Succentor. We pray for all those involved in the offering of worship. O God, whom saints and angels delight to worship in heaven, be ever present with your servants who seek through art and music to perfect the praises offered by your people on earth. Grant to them even now glimpses of your beauty, and make them worthy at length to behold it unveiled for evermore. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Though we are unable to witness the licensing of the new bishop's chaplain, we pray for the bishop and for all who are involved in the life and ministry of this diocese. Praying for your blessing on the new ministry of Nick as bishop's chaplain, who begins this week. O God, by your grace you have called us in this diocese to a goodly fellowship of faith. Bless our bishops and other clergy and all our people. Grant that your word may be truly preached and truly heard, your sacraments faithfully administered and faithfully received. By your Spirit, fashion our lives according to the example of your Son, and grant that we may show the power of your love to all among whom we live. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. So we pray, as at Evensong every day, for Stephen, our bishop, for Bishops David and Nicholas, and for our Diocese of Lincoln. Joining others today in praying especially for the church communities of Kirkby Lathorpe. We pray for the life and ministry of the cathedral. And on this day of the month, we pray for the Cathedral Council and the College of Canons. We pray too for the members of this cathedral foundation of the Blessed Virgin Mary of Lincoln, both living and departed. Among those who died on this day in years past, we pray for Anthony Reynolds, prebendary of Welton Rivel, sometime vicar of Wellingore, who died in 1809, and for Frederick Charles Massingbird, prebendary of Thorngate, Chancellor of Lincoln and Rector of Ormsby, who died in 1872. And we also remember those whose mortal remains are buried in the cathedral, particularly today praying for William Annick, prebendary of Buckton and Bishop of Lincoln, who died in 1449. And so we use the prayer laid down by St. Hugh for the daily use of the canons of this cathedral church. Almighty and eternal God, you are Lord both of the living and the dead, and have pity on all those whom you know will be yours in faith and works. We humbly beseech you that those for whom we have determined to offer our prayers, whether the present age yet holds them in the flesh, or the age to come has already received them out of the body, may of your merciful goodness come to pardon of all their sins, and so be held worthy of eternal joys. Through our Lord, who lives and reigns with you, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God for ever and ever. Amen. So we unite all our thoughts and prayers in the words of the grace. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all, evermore. Collection is not taken during the course of this service, but there is an opportunity to contribute to the cathedral's music fund as you leave the cathedral church this evening. We stand now and, singing from the green hymn books, we sing hymn 9.